Hello, this is the project introduction video for part 2 of the project that involves link analysis. I hope you had fun doing part 1 because you will be using the code from that part as the starting point for this project. There are two main tasks in this part. The first task is about computing the authorities and hubs of a set of documents, and the second task is about computing the page rank of the entire corpus. Let us look at the first task, authorities and hubs, which is one way of evaluating link-based importance of a page. As you can imagine, finding the authorities and hubs score for every document in the corpus might be interesting, but it is not directly useful to finding a set of results to show to the user. In order to find a set of authoritative pages relevant to the query that the user has issued, we take a different approach. We first use the vector similarity code from part 1 of the project to get the top k set of relevant documents. We call these documents the root set. Then, using the link analysis tools provided to you as part of the problem statement, you will find all the pages that these guys link to, as well as all the pages that link to these guys. The set of all these pages taken together is called the base set. On this base set, you will need to compute the authorities and hubs. In order to compute the value, as you should know from the slides, you create the adjacency matrix for the pages using the new code sample provided as part of the problem statement. After you construct the adjacency matrix, you can find the authorities and hubs score using the power iteration method as mentioned in the slides. Finally, you can display the top 10 authorities and top 10 hubs to the user. Now let us look at the code in some detail. The project description page has a link to download some new files. In these files, the int citations and int links files are the data files that contain the link structure of the entire corpus. They contain the information about which documents point to which documents. The linked analysis.java file contains some code to help you read these files and quickly find the link structure for a given page. To set up this experiment, you should copy the int citations and int links files to your project folder and the linked analysis.java file to the appropriate package inside your source folder. Now let us look inside the linked analysis.java file. The first part of this file is just the code that reads in the links and citations files and stores them in memory for quick retrieval later. If you scroll to the bottom of the file, you will see a small worked out example in the main function, which you should use as a starting point. In the main function, the first two lines show you how to create a link analysis object. You have to first set the number of documents in your corpus, which you can find by using the maxdoc function from part 1. Then, you can create an object of type link analysis. After creating this object, you can find the documents that a given document points to by calling the getLinks function. For example, here we see how to find all the document numbers that document number 3 is pointing to. Similarly, we can also find all the document numbers that contain a link to 3 by calling the getCitations function. Using these functions repeatedly, you will be able to create an adjacency matrix for whatever set of documents you want. For this question, you need to submit the code by email, print out the document numbers for the top 10 authorities and top 10 hubs, and then answer the analysis questions. Let's go over the analysis questions. The first one asks you how the size of the root set affects the relevance of the results. You will need to issue some queries and vary the root set size k and judge whether authorities and the hubs you obtain are better for lower k values or higher k values. And you have to justify your answer with a logical explanation. Similarly, the second question asks how the size of the root set affects the time taken. The third analysis question requires you to evaluate which parts of the algorithm took how much time. The second task is about PageRank, which is the algorithm that made Google famous. There are three things you should keep in mind before you begin computing the PageRank values. The first is that PageRank is a global score. It does not depend on a single user or a query, and thus, the computation for PageRank needs to be done over the entire corpus. For even a small corpus like this, and 25,000 documents is a tiny corpus, computing PageRank in a naive manner will not work. This is because PageRank is computed on the entire adjacency matrix of the entire corpus, and therefore the size of the matrix is 25,000 by 25,000. And if you put a float value in each cell, you have 4 bytes per entry. That translates to about 2.33 GB of memory, which some of the recent computers do have, but is not the fastest or the smartest way of doing it. And if your corpus was even slightly larger than 25K documents, this code will fail. What you should do instead is to think about ways around this problem. I can suggest 2 ways. The first is not to have a matrix at all in memory. Whenever your algorithm needs to find the particular value of an item in the matrix, you just compute it on the fly using link analysis tools. The other idea is to use this data structure called sparse matrices to help reduce the amount of memory you need to store on the system. Before you use sparse matrices, take some time to consider whether the matrix you are about to create is really all that sparse or not. The second tip is to use is that you have to take care of sync nodes and the reset matrix. In both these cases, you do not need to create a whole new matrix to store these values. You can modify your code to automatically add these numbers when required. The third and final thing is that you have to normalize the PageRank values to match the cosine similarity values. As you know, the score of each document is a combination of its PageRank score and its vector similarity score. The vector similarity scores are numbers in the range of 0.1 to 0.2. However, PageRank values are much, much lower, in the range of 10 to the minus 4. To make this addition meaningful, you have to normalize the PageRank values so that they become comparable to the vector space similarity numbers. For this question, you have to submit your code, sample output, and the answers to the analysis questions. In the analysis questions, the first one is a comparison question. Having implemented a number of different ranking functions like DFIDF, authorities and hubs, page ranks, the obvious question is which is the best one. You have to run some queries against all these systems and judge which the best one was and justify your answer. The next question asks you to vary the PageRank parameters W and C and judge whether it makes the results better or worse. The next question is about the convergence of PageRank. The one after that is about the document with the highest PageRank. The last question asks you whether there is any correlation between the pages that have high authority and hub values and high PageRank values. A formal analysis of correlation is not required, however, you have to substantiate your answer with evidence from the experiments. The extra credit part is about building a UI. A UI is useful for presenting your work as well as putting screenshots in your report. When building the UI, please understand that redirecting the console output to a GUI text box does not constitute a UI. You have to build a simple but non-trivial UI. If you think of any other interesting insights, challenges, or analysis, feel free to submit them for extra credit. Good luck!